Try this question, children. An office opens at 10 a.m. and closes at 6 p.m. Lunch interval is for 30 minutes. What is the ratio of lunch interval to total period in the office? Children, please type the answers in the chat box. Do not shout. So children, here, he is asking the ratio of lunch interval to total period in the office. So children, from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m., how many hours? It is 8 hours, isn't it? From 10 a.m. to 6 p.m., we have 8 hours. 8 hours means what? 8 into 60 minutes, because 1 hour is 60. Now here he is asking the ratio of lunch interval to total period in the office. That means what? 30 is the lunch minutes. Children, we have to be careful that we have to convert everything in the minutes here, because lunch interval is in minutes. So time in the office should also be in minutes. 8 hours is there. Now 1 hour is 1 hour is 60 minutes. So 8 hour will be 8 into 60. So 30 by 8 into 60 will be, so this, if I cut this,
180.
So that will be 1 by 60. 1 by 16 is nothing but 1 is to 16. Pragya, is that clear, Pragya? Children, try this. Cost of dozen pens is 180 and cost of 8 ball pens is 56. Pen to a ball pen. Okay. Yes. So children, dozen means what? 12 pens, right? The cost of 12 pens is 180. Children, dozen means 12. The cost of 12 pens is 180. So one pen will be what? 1 into 180 by 12. So 180 by 12, children, this is equal to 15. The cost of a pen is 15. And 8 ball pens are costing 56. 8 pens are costing 56. So one pen will be 1 into 56 by 8. That is equal to 7. So children, the answer is 15 is to 7. Neha, is it clear now? Ekta earns 1500 in 10 days. How much she will earn in 30 days? Children, this is easy. Anjali, it is C or D?
Sir, it's me who said it is D.
No, I'm asking Anjali. Anjali gave the answer as C, so I'm asking Anjali. So children, here I have 1500 for 10 days. If a person is earning 1500 for 30 days, it will be 30 into 1500 by 10. So 3 into 1500 is rupees 4500.